And obviously, the obvious people, the most famous female boxers are probably DAZN Cruz, but she's above you. Carissa Shields. I would throw Napoleon Kaufman in there. Alicia Kaufman. I think that's her name. And
a lot of time with women, and I don't really want to generalize, but it is what it is. I think that a lot of times when they don't possess certain things that other people possess, they feel like they got to hold the spotlight all to themselves. Now, we're in a very competitive sport as a whole. So do I expect to be kumbaya with everybody that I'm going to fight? No, but I also, at the same time, this is a sport. You know, if you give me respect, I'm going to get respect. You know, if you give respect, to get respect. When we get into that ring, you know, all bets is off. Mm-hmm. We came to handle business and win. But after that, I'm going to respect you. I'm going to tip my hat to you because I know outside of this how challenging it is just to be a boxer, especially at a high level. And I think that a lot of times women in this sport, at least, really hold each other back because you said you want to tear each other down or like really shelter your little spotlight when we can't build a sport if we're not really like, look, is this girl I can fight? Is this girl I can fight? There's some really talented girls out here. But if we never get the spotlight or we never get the shine or we never get the exposure, how, you know.
Got that. Now, you and Alicia Napoleon is her name, right? Alicia Napoleon, mm-hmm. her name. How come y'all never fought? It seemed like y'all...
I don't know. Go ask Ludabella.
Well, he gonna get the interview. I mean, he gonna get the interview. So every name you mention on this shuttle is definitely gonna hear everything that you say. So
yeah, I mean, I think that's a great fight. I think that Alicia Napoleon is talented. I think that it's a great fight. I think she's tough. I think she can fight. I think the fans want to see that fight. You know, I would love to have that fight. Mm-hmm. Hannah Gabriels is under Ludabella management. That's a great fight. You know, I'm her mandatory. It's some women out here that's handling business, and I would love to, you know, fight them. I would love for those opportunities. So your guess is as good as mine.
Has it ever been presented to you, or have you ever offered? Or
no, I've asked numerous times. I've asked numerous times to fight pretty much all of the girls that's within my weight class that I can fight. You name them, from Clarissa Shields to Hannah Gabriel to Alicia Napoleon to Callie Reese. I try to make a fight with Tori Nelson, but it's like I can only do so much. And not to take anything away from them, maybe they want to fight too. It's a lot of business that goes on the outside. I mean, on the, you know, back end that people don't really know about. But I've tried to email coaches, I've emailed managers before. I tried to get the fight to happen with Cornejo, reached out to her manager personally myself to try to facilitate that fight and then bring it to DaBella and say, hey, we had 360 that wanted to give us the fight, but they turned the fight down.
You've actually went out of your way and put on all three hats, promoter, fighter, manager.
Several times. And so it's very irritating and very frustrating when you see people get online and say, oh, you ducking this person, are you ducking that person? When I don't have to duck a soul, you know, I don't have to duck a soul. I chose boxing. I know I can fight. I know I'm talented, and I want to challenge myself to fight the best so that I can prove and solidify my spot. So don't come at me. Don't play with me.
Has it ever been any like personal conversation with you and Carissa Shields at all? Salute to the queen. Salute to the queen, pound for pound boxing channel. Salute to the queen.
Thank you. yes. So Clarissa and I definitely have a history. I went to the 2012 games as alternate in London when the first time for the women to go to the Olympics. So we've been teammates before. So we have some history. I've been to the Olympic trials 2 times with a bronze medal. We fought in the amateurs before. We've been on the same team before. We traveled out of the country before on Team USA. So, of course, honestly, I didn't really have no issues with old girl. There was an interview some years back, and she tried to take the interview out of context and made it seem as if I was hating on her or Matt, or, you know, it was just really bullshit. But reality is she really was just jealous of me and my shine. She was jealous that, you know, people were excited about me. I fought on the Rock Nation card. People like me. You know, I'm a good person. People gonna love me, period.
We'll get to the Egypt question later on down the line.
I'll definitely answer.
Yeah. Yes. We'll get to that. I appreciate you, honey. So you guys have sparred as well.
We've been in camp together numerous times. I've been to London as her sparring partner. I've been on Team USA for 3-4 years. So, of course,
Yeah. How many rounds?
That's how I got to go as a foreign partner because.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I'm talking over the guests. I'm sorry. I'm just getting excited. You know, because Carissa's going to watch this. That's why. Carissa's going to watch this. That's why.
Yeah, so numerous rounds. Mm-hmm. Yes, numerous rounds.
Like too many rounds to count.
You said how many rounds to count? Probably, if I had to put a number on it, and we fought several times in amateurs too, but probably maybe 15 rounds, maybe 12, 15 rounds, something like that.
That's definitely enough. And how did it go in amateurs?
I felt like I got robbed out of some decisions in amateurs, and I'm not the type of person to sit up here and be like, oh, they robbed me. And, you know, like, I keep it real. I felt like some of the decisions, if she wasn't who she was and she didn't have the title of having the Olympic gold medal behind her, I think that some of the decisions would have went separately. Yeah. We fought to some split decisions. Like, most of our decisions have all been split decisions, I think, besides one. And the that it wasn't a split decision, I really felt like I got robbed, and they really gave her all the rounds, and I really felt some type of way about that. But we have a long history. I think that it's only right that we get to get it on. I think that she tries to belittle me and make it seem like I'm scared of her. But the truth is in the pudding. Like, you know what time it is. I know what time it is. Like, it ain't a scared bone in my body, baby. You sitting that contract and we making it happen. And that's that on that.
I didn't know the amateur records was so close in terms of split. How many times did y'all fight?
I think we fought 3 times in amateurs.
3 times.
If I'm not mistaken. And we fought in the Olympic trials. We fought in the Nationals and some other tournament. I can't recall which tournament.
2 split decisions and 1 UD.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, so y'all pretty much, y'all right in the line. And now it's just who's better as a pro now.